Converting your personal YouTube channel into a brand account can get a little bit sticky. I'm not gonna lie to you. I wanted to share with you a tutorial that I normally share with my own clients on the back end. At the end of the day, if you do this wrong, you could be deleting your channel. And we don't want that to happen. Follow this tutorial step by step, and you should be good to go. If you are in the process of optimizing your YouTube channel and getting it set up the best way possible, I would totally encourage you to download my free YouTube Quick Start Guide that gives you everything that you need to launch your channel the right way. You'll have video tutorial templates and resources there to help make it really, really fast to get your channel up and running. So let's go ahead and dive into this tutorial.
All right, so in this video, I'm going to walk you through how to move your personal YouTube channel into a brand account. It's very, very simple. Let's go ahead and walk through it. I wanted to like make this personal account with all of the things so that you can kind of see what stays and what doesn't. Okay, so I have the handle here. I have the channel description, the links here, the subscriber, the video. The video has some views on it, and the video also has comments on it. It has two comments on it. It has two comments right there. Now that you see the lay of the land, it has playlists and there's posts. I wanted to just like post these things so that you kind of would know like if anything disappears or something that answers your questions. First things first, you go to your channel that you want to transfer into a brand account. I want to do Jesse's Catnip Corner. I want to make that into a brand account. So I'm going to go here. As you see, I'm already on Jesse's Catnip Corner. And then I'm going to go to settings. And then I'm going to go to create a new channel. So this should be a brand channel by the time that we do this. So we're going to do Jesse's. We're just going to name this something random. Jesse's brand account. And so you don't have to even worry about this stuff because this is mostly like a shell account. It's going to be deleted. So we're going to create channel. Now we just need to go to start log back in. Okay, as you can see, this is Jesse's brand account. You can now add or remove managers, okay? Make sure that you are on Jesse's Catnip Corner. You have to make sure that, okay? I don't want you to delete the wrong thing. And now on the account that you want to move over, you're gonna go to its settings. You're gonna go to View Advanced Settings, and then you're gonna go to Move This Channel to a Brand Account. After you finish verifying, you should be taken to this page here. And we're gonna be moving your YouTube channel to a different account. This is the channel that's being moved. You should be seeing your real channel here. Your real channel should be here. The channel that you just made should be here. And you are going to be moving it into here. And as you can see, I already have one subscriber, one video, and two playlists right here, okay? So I know that this is the right one for me. And now I'm going to press replace because I'm going to be moving this into here. This is the part where everyone gets kind of scared, but as long as you see your main channel, the one that you want to move into a brand account is right here, and the fake account or the shell account that you just made is right here, you're going to be just fine. Press replace. And then it's going to tell you right here, are you sure that you want to delete this channel? We definitely want to delete Jesse's brand account. That's the one that we just made. And so it's going to tell you that if you do that, these things will be deleted. And that makes sense because this account is going to be deleted. And you already know, just to double check, that you know that this is not the account that you are not deleting your personal account because it has no playlists, it has no videos, and it has no subscribers. So it is not the one that you have. So you're going to say, I wish to proceed. And let's go ahead and delete this channel. And then it says that, are you sure that you want to move and update your channel? Yes. After the move, that brand account is going to now be what I want my personal account to be. When you have switched account, you're going to see two things here, two channels here. And you're going to see your brand account that's made right here. And then you're going to see your, like, this is like your email account. This doesn't have a channel attached to it. It's just like a way for you if you want to just watch videos without having an account. Like, you're not going to be able to do anything unless you create an account here. Your Jesse's Catnip Corner is right here, right? This is the brand account. And we know that that is the brand account by going here. And now we see add or remove managers. Let's see if everything is still there. We have the title, the URL, the handle, the description, the links, the one subscriber is still there. The one video is there. The one video is there. The playlists are right here. Playlists are right here. Video is right here. Now, and the post is right here. Now, the only thing that I think one of my members had mentioned is that the playlist section goes away, but that should come back in a few, give it a few hours or days and it would be there. It may be gone inside a YouTube studio, but it still is there. It still is gonna be there. Just give it some time to come back. You just move your channel to a brand account. That's the only thing. If you wanna be super thorough, then just take a screenshot of all of your playlists and what videos you had in them, and then go from there. From what we have seen, the playlists do come back after a while, and if not, always feel free to contact YouTube support. I hope that this was helpful. I hope that this answers any questions that you may have, or kind of eliminate any fears about moving your channel to a brand account and like knowing like what you actually like lose and what you are able to keep. Y'all have a good one. Thank you for watching.
Now you have all the steps to go ahead and try it on your own. Watch this video as many times as you need. Even put it up side by side and make sure that you don't mess up anything, and you should be good to go. If you are in the process of setting up your YouTube channel the best way possible, then I definitely encourage you to grab my free quick start guide that walks you through everything that you need to get it set up and optimized the right way. I give you so many video tutorials, resources, and templates to make it very, very easy for you to implement. Go ahead and grab that in the video description, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.